As you become better using SPSS statistics software to clean data, you will want to do quick comparisons of subgroups in your data, or to isolate one group in particular. Now, this is where split file processing really shines. Split file allows you to compare groups on a given variable or to run separate analyses on two subgroups of your data. We're going to dive deeper into split file processing in SPSS. By default, SPSS includes all of the cases in your dataset when you do an analysis. However, SPSS allows you to split a file and then perform a separate analysis for each subgroup. This allows you to see the descriptive statistics for your group separately for data cleaning or data exploration. You can split a numeric or scale variable by a nominal, ordinal, or a string variable. When you use a split file command, SPSS will quietly sort the cases before splitting them. This is because the split file procedure creates a new subgroup each time it encounters a different value for one of your grouping variables. So if you did not sort your data first, you would have dozens of categories, even though you only had actually two groups. The sorting is done by default, so it's nothing that you need to think about unless you are using syntax. For this example, we are using the demo.sav dataset that comes with SPSS. To find out how to open this dataset, check the links in the description. We will use the continuous variable income as our scale variable, which we will split by gender, our dichotomous nominal or categorical variable. And if we need a second scale variable, we will use age. To split your data file into separate groups for analysis, go to Data, Split File. Here we see the Split File dialog box. We are going to use the categorical variable gender to split the continuous variable income. Begin by displaying the variable names using a right click. For this first example, we're going to get the results from all split file groups in the same table. Select Compare Groups, and then move gender into the box Groups Based On. If the file was already sorted by gender, you could save a few milliseconds of processing time by selecting File is Already Sorted. This only really matters if you have a very large data set or a really slow computer. We will let SPSS sort our data for us. Click OK. Now that we have split the file, we are ready to analyze the income variable. We will do two analyses. First, we'll get some descriptive statistics, and then we will do a correlation. Go to Analyze, Descriptive Statistics, Frequencies. We will use the income variable. Click on Statistics and choose Mean, Median, Standard Deviation. Now click Continue. Let's turn off the frequency tables and click OK. For the second analysis, we are going to analyze using a scale variable. Go to Analyze, Correlate, Bivariate. We will correlate income with the scale variable age. And click OK. Here we see the results for males and again for females. Both are in the same table. The correlation matrices are in the same pivot table. So this would be useful to quickly compare the descriptive statistics for each group. Let's run a different analysis in which we keep the groups separate. Use the dialog recall button to bring back the split file dialog box. This time, select Organize Output by Groups. We are already using the gender variable, so click OK. We see that the split file is still on, so any analyses that we run will be presented in two pivot tables, one table for females and one table for males. Use the dialog recall button to rerun our previous frequency analysis. Click OK. And we can rerun the correlation too. We see that the pivot tables for the descriptive statistics are now created separately. SPSS has also created separate correlation matrices, one for males and one for females. This technique would be most useful if we really only wanted to use the findings for one subgroup, so we could just ignore the other group. Or if we wanted to display split findings side by side, for example, on a poster. Now we need to know how to turn the split file processing on and off. After you split the file, the split remains in effect for the rest of the session until you turn it off. A message "split by gender" appears in the status bar here at the bottom of the application window. It tells you that the split file processing is still in effect. To turn it off, go to Data, Split File. Set the button to Analyze All Cases. You can click OK, or a second option is to simply click the Reset button. Either of these options will turn off split file processing. This is also easy to do with syntax, using the command split file off, period.